Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. In the PySpark 101 tutorial, in this video I am going to talk about sample transformation. Okay, so how can we use sample transformation on the RDD? Before going to the topic, let me minimize the recording window. Now I will walk you through the program. Okay, so okay, first of all, what is sample transformation does? Okay, basically it is going to return you the sample subset of from your RDD. Okay, so how it is going to design the sample is based on the fraction value you give, okay, and also seed, the seed parameter, fraction parameter, and seed parameter, okay. There is another parameter called with replacement, okay. So with replacement, generally why it is used is if you give with replacement equal to true, it is going to actually sample the multiple times, it is going to sample the each element in your RDD, it's going to do the multiple times. It's going to sample multiple times in your RDD. Okay, I will show you how it works. Okay, so in this program, so I just imported the PySpark library. Okay, this is the entry point of the PySpark program. Okay, so we create the Spark session object. Now I have a Python list which contains a number 1 to 10. Okay, I convert this Python list into RDD. Okay, so I convert this into RDD. Okay, once I convert into this RDD with three partitions, okay, so I will get a number RDD, right? So in the number RDD, there it has number 1 to 10. Okay, now I am going to apply the sample transformation. Okay, first I will do with the replacement false and the fraction equal to 0.5 and seed equal to 1. So basically, seed is generally used for generate a random sequence, same sequence, to generate a random sequence in same manner. Like if you say first I run this sample, say you send it to some random numbers. Okay, so it gets the random number as 1 to 5. Okay, you are giving a seed as 1. So if you are going to again run that random sequence again, like the random function, If you give the same seed, you will get the same random sequence. That's the use of seed. Okay. Now I will give the with replacement as false. I will just try to run this program. Okay. So after this sample, after doing the sample transformation, I am just doing the collect and I am displaying the value. Okay. First I am just displaying as the list and then iterating each element I am showing you. So let me run this program. So it is going to create the Spark session object and then create the RDD and it will do the sampling and it will return you the value. Okay, so ideally if you give fraction as 0.5, you should get actually 50% from that RDD. Okay, so we have 10 elements. Actually we should get 5 elements, but we have got only 4 elements. Actually in the document itself they mentioned this is not guaranteed to provide exactly the fraction specified of the total of the total count of the given data frame. Okay, so they're saying it is not actually guaranteed that it will return that value based on the same fraction which you provided in the RDD. Actually you get actually different numbers. Okay, so if I give actually the 0.4, okay, actually ideally I should get 4 elements, but I'll get only 1 element. So it will actually again it will create the transformation, the Spark session object and create the RDD and apply. See here, you get 1 number. So ideally it should get, but sometime it is not getting. Okay, so now what I'll do is so this fraction value will be 0 to 1 if the with replacement is false. If with replacement equal to true, then it should be a greater than 0. That's what the documentation says, it should be greater than 0. So I'll just give 2, okay, or 3. I'll give the fraction as 3. Now I'll run this program. So basically it will actually sample your RDD, okay, and each element it will actually try to do multiple sample multiple times. You can see it in the result. See here, if you look at here, we have 1 to 10. So it has sampled three times, and five times it sampled, and four also sampled four times. Okay, and except three, it sampled other numbers. Six did not sample, and so on. Okay. Okay, so this is how the sample transformation works. Okay, we can actually get this. If you want to get the subset, you can actually make it as with replacement false, and it will actually give you the subset from your RDD. If you actually want to increase the sample, basically you want to actually multiple times you want to repeat that elements in your RDD, then you can use the with replacement. So this is the usage of the sample RDD. I hope you understood. If you have any queries, please post it on the video's description section. Thank you so much, friends. See you in the next video.